Okay, there we go. We got Kevin in here. Let's
there
go.
There we go. We're gonna have to. So that might be a Orchid versus Isako.
Almost certainly.
Yeah.
Almost certainly. I want other game developers to do what Arxis is doing and like go back and make their like big tentpole fighting games have rollback. Like I know Marvel is a thing with like bad license, like just awful like to deal with licensing and whatnot.
Oh, yeah.
But like Street Fighter 4 with rollback would be great. I would like to see MK9 and the original Injustice with rollback.
Yep, that would be great. Or a better rollback for Tekken, that would be also good. A better integration of it.
Okay.
And yep. Because I know Tekken 7 is a incredible fun game to watch.
Mm-hmm. Oh my god, catches the back dash.
Oh
can
boy.
Go anywhere.
Yeah, Juno is establishing the pressure here. And the boats on the lows.
Oh, she went for parry, but Kevin jumping. Conchita
yep.
jumping. Sorry, I don't mean to keep saying the wrong name.
Smash. Because they already made their money.
Yeah, Smash is. They're still making their money.
Yep.
Smash is never getting rollback.
No, it's never gonna get rollback until the players stop playing the game.
No, I mean until people make it for Switch emulators. We got Slippy for a melee.
Yeah, melee.
Oh my god, Flip,
melee rollback.
Shadow Flip Flag, even normal Flip Flag is such a good anti-air, surprisingly.
Yep. Yeah, it covers a lot of range, and the Vengeance counter would have recaptured.
Oh, she went for reset.
Well,
I
that's
love it.
Yeah. Yeah, never be greedy with the dashes with the Sako because that was so good. Yeah, Shadow Influence.
Oh, I love the choice of backdash, but no, you cannot Shadow Counter.
No, it's not vulnerable on the projectile. It's not projectile invincible on the very early frames.
Hey, Turbok, I appreciate it. Oh yeah, that. Gonna stop it! Gets the connection with the Shadow Flick Flag off the Fire Cat.
Head. Grenade. Heavy Flick Flag. Oh, that's gonna be killed. Yeah.
God. Orchid does some damage.
One step closer to flushing out Ultra Tech.
Flushing out Ultra Tech and.
Yeah, you gotta watch
Gold
out.
Gold Girls.
Hal, you gotta watch out for those tick throws. Yeah, the new Jin's here, for sure. Also, I think the majority of this bracket is Chilean players. Chile has really been showing up for these, I should say.
Yeah, we're getting some World Warriors! Woo!
Street Fighter who? We got KI.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh my god, didn't quite get the backside. I think she was trying to catch a backdash.
Yeah, extended Debbie.
Oh, she woke up and did the grenade. I don't know what she was trying to do. Awfully a grab, but I don't think there was enough frames there to do it.
She gets that level 4 Ender Soul.
Okay, she's kind of dying off these parries. The overhead is. I usually try to react with parrying myself on. Yeah, Judo's just kind of throwing stuff out here.
Yeah, that's not the gym that we've seen earlier. Yeah.
Live by the parry, die by the parry.
Yeah. I'm not sure about the extension with the Shadow Warriors on, but hey. Better make sure that the damage is all cashed out.
Anybody with NR?
There you go.
Anybody with NRO is Chile, and also Big Bostano, I'm pretty sure, is Chilean as well. I could be wrong about that, but I'm pretty sure.
There's a lot of attempts with the parry that could have been possible.
So much damage.
Oh my god. 61%.
Oh yeah, get that fucking punish. Hisako can definitely do this.
Yeah. of all characters, that's the one.
Oh my god, no air buster. What happened there?
Oh, I missed something.
I don't know what Conchita tried to do there. I assume it was an air buster, but it got caught out. I don't even know what the hell just happened.
There was
I didn't see a single frame of activeness on whatever orc it is. I didn't even see the startup. I have no idea what Conchita tried to do there.
I have an answer. Keats?
No. Keith has left us to the wind.
Yeah, I know. Rumbleverse. And give it a shot, though. It's pretty good. Give Rumbleverse a shot. Just for fun. You don't need to play it competitively. Just give it a shot.
Okay, here we go. We got the Ichi-san mix-ups.
Yeah, and Kevin is establishing what we've seen earlier in the first match. And now that level 4 and definitely a possession ender after this. No, influence ender. That's a choice. I've seen so many Isako going for the ender.
I would like to see Juno go for more of that was opener ender. No, wait, that's just a grab. But I would like to see her go for the parry off of jump ins. She seems to just kind of be doing it on her wake up. Which, Kevin Conchita seems to be playing around that. Oh my god, the parry!
Oh, that is. Yup.
You think it's your turn just because you popped instinct? I don't think so.
Because she's invincible during the old animation of the Vengeance counter when the full thing is parried. So, the cat was pointless. And now, you know, I was gonna say, you need to pop that instinct.
And again with the
good reaction under Shadow Influence. That was so.
Hey, what's up, D100?
Oh, that could have been a good thick throw.
Oh, she's still trying to throw.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. You need those low parries now.
Don't get close.
You can parry on with every single parry button when you are in instinct. So there's no real.
Nice. I'm not sure why Juno's trying to counter break an orchid. Although, to be fair, Kevin's not really shown much of.
That didn't kill.
Oh, no, yeah.
Chip damage. Bob Instinct. Oh, nice pair. Don't luck. Oh! One chance break. There you go.
Oh my god.
Wow.
Yeah, I've not really seen Kevin use the Shadowbreaker tech too much, so I guess.
I mean, that was a good reset. That was the one time that influence paid off, and it really paid off with the full Shadow Ender level 4. Was that Absolute on screen instead?
No, that's definitely Juno.
That rollback is awful. It happens, mate. It happens.
There's some distance going here between these two players.
Alright, it's 1-1, I think.
It's 2-1.
It's Juno's 2-1?
Juno's got 2.
Oh!
Well, it's getting a little more intense here.
Yeah, the rollback can actually be a bit of a pain, but the influence is still getting in.
Nice
catch on the back dash. Air on your son. Oh, there you go, that's a punish.
Boom, 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 boom. Yeah, just running away. Doesn't want to deal with that grenade at all. Catches the jump out. Catches another pre-jump frame, I'm pretty sure.
Yep. Yeah, spend that meter. Level 4. Oh, the greed.
She even extended the combo. Oh, yep. What did the quick wake up?
There was some frames where Juno could have popped the instinct to vengeance counter, but there we go. I mean, one hit can actually stop. Oh, the descent with the stop by the cat. Oh, too many descents. That was not a good decision.
Yeah, Kevin's ready for it.
Yeah. Yeah, this is where the entires are gonna be necessity, and this can do a lot of damage now. Again, Those 40% combos are gonna bite you.
Oh, she keeps trying to jump. Went for the high parry, but it was low.
Yeah, that was the moment that where instinct needed to be popped to get a full parry. One step closer to flushing out Ultra Tech. Never sit on an instinct on the second life bar. Use it as soon as you can, even though he's not gonna be the best option. Use that instinct, especially with this Akko, because it will save you.
Does he still...
I understand Juno taking a step up, a step away, and coming back. There's nothing wrong taking a breather. Yes, Thrash, maybe you can actually keep going, sorry.
No, I was just... It's not anything important. Does Elon Musk even sell flamethrowers anymore? I feel like that was a very limited time thing. That's what they're talking about, chat. Or at least Alex and Charhopper.
And Elon Musk flamethrower.
Alex loves Elon Musk. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Oh my god, just descent off the heavy...
Yeah, have you heard of Tesla XB? Tesla XB?
Oh yeah?
Yeah. That was a bad joke. Okay, I'm canceling myself.
Okay.
And now Juno is Oh, that was a good vengeance!
She recovered her time so she could do it.
Yep. Yeah, the overhead from Orchid are true and vulnerable. That's a bad idea for Yasako. You need those vengeance counter ready. And now, Kevin was ready for the Shadow Influence. And that's the match point here.
Oh, no.
Oh, check your lows.
Oh, she mistimed it.
Yeah, Kevin could have done even more damage. Oh, this is going to be really...
Yeah, she's really trying to fight out of this instinct, but she should not be. She should be blocking.
And that... Oof! I think Kevin was trying to go for the... I think that Kevin was trying to go for the Ultra at some point, but yeah.
Ultra.
Yeah. Juno was doing exceptionally well at some point, and Kevin managed to adapt.
If I had to, like, I'm not, like, the best coach or whatever, but I feel like the one thing she needs to do is just sometimes calm down a bit.
Mm-hmm.
Like, she is constantly going in at full speed, and sometimes that's just not always going to be the best plan.
Yeah.
Especially
with Isako, I think you need to be... The more calm Isako player is, in my opinion, that can be the most dangerous player in the world. Because really, just the fear of getting grabbed, the fear of getting countered, and just using the possession to bait into a counter, that can do a lot of stuff. And honestly, Isako got the normals to poke everybody out of range.
Yeah, her normals are quite massive. And
heavy punch is the her far standing heavy punch is the far standing heavy kick of Rash.